So we're here at the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana, California. You have some of your fighters here. What are they doing, Brandon?
Well, this whole week, the gym is focusing on our straight punches. So what these two fighters are doing is a little, one's on offense, one's on defense. The one that's on offense gets to exclusively use straight punches.
Just jabbing the whole time?
No, and the straight right, and different distances with it, different types of timing with it, different types of defense for it. After these guys just get real used to those straight shots, which should be the mainstay of our boxing. And then here on the board...
Speaking of straight punches.
Yeah, here on the board, we just have some highlighted points that I want these guys to know about. So, of course, we're working straight punches. And pretty self-explanatory, straight out, straight back.
What does that mean?
That means, look, from my guard, I need to line up my fist to my target. I need to step in and rotate and come out nice and straight, get a full extension out of my shot, not overcommit. And then I need to pull it right back to where it came from in one plane of motion. What a lot of fighters do wrong is they'll put their hands to the side of their head. So what this does, setback, is it makes it impossible to hit you with a straight shot. If you're right in front of me, but this is where my guard is, I will have to loop around in order to hit you.
More time.
And of course, we're only talking about a split second.
So show me how would you, if you're not gonna put it near your face, you still wanna protect your chin.
So of course, that's exactly what you wanna do. You wanna protect your chin. So people who are putting their hands to the side, you're not really protecting anything. So
but it looks good.
It looks good, but what look even better is getting it more of a guarding position where now my opponent's going to be forced to have to loop his shots to get a clean shot on me, and plus I will be ready to step in nice and straight with that shot. Fighters who just really feel comfortable with the side of their head, what they need to do is they need to step a little bit diagonal with their front foot to put their right hand in a straight position and then come back into that boxing stance. So okay. That's what I have them working there, straight punches, no hitches. There should be no change in the rhythm. It should just come straight from the guard and straight back. You should never cock, you should never wind up, you should never let your opponent know anything is gonna happen. And another important thing is your elbow needs to stay very tight and locked towards your body. I see a lot of fighters start letting their elbows fling out to the side. Your opponent's gonna see that. It's gonna be a warning that a shot's gonna come, and he's gonna take advantage of that.
But a lot of people do cock their punches. I see them, especially even when they're doing mitts. Do you see when they wind up for it? And it's a bad habit, because then that's how you get used to hitting.
It's a bad habit, that's how you get used to hitting, and whether or not you pay for it today, tomorrow, next week, eventually, somebody's gonna make you pay for that lack of technique. You should always try to work on being as perfect as you possibly can.
So, okay, what's the next thing?
Here we got no drops or curls. That kind of goes on the same mode as I'm saying. If I have my hand to the side, it will have to curl around. It will have to loop around. Also, what you'll notice a lot of fighters do is they'll start with a good guard, and before they throw their shot, they'll drop it down and throw it out. It's another warning sign for your opponent, and it leaves a great countering opportunity as that hand drops. You want to make sure that you don't do that.
Can you show me like a 3-4 good punches in a row where you're not doing anything wrong? Just like that. Okay.
Out from the head, back to the same exact place. I mean, this is kind of boxing 101. This is my guard. It goes into our idea of not cocking back our punches or anything like that. And look, this is where it's gonna start, bink, and that's where it's gonna end from. I also have this rotational motion as it comes out. That allows me to keep my elbow in nice and tight. If I try to push, then my elbow is gonna be forced to come out to the side. So instead I want to rotate and then come on back with that same reverse rotation. The same way a bullet leaving a gun, the same way an arrow leaving a bow rotates as it travels through the air. It helps you maintain power and speed and keep a forward straight trajectory all at the same time. So that's the science behind that one.
There you have it. Thank you so much. Stay tuned for more from the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana. FiestaReporting.com. I'm Rolly Sekback.
Reporting.